Sometimes you have to bring like a dessert or something to a party or something, and everybody likes to have the best, you know, dessert that everybody just eats up, and you know, people love. Chocolate Sybil Cake. Sybil. Like the girl with multiple personality disorders. Anyway, Chocolate Sybil Cake. So for the cake, you need a half a cup or one stick of butter. Yeah, this way we don't talk about what's in the cake. Softened. So soften the butter. One cup of sugar. Four eggs. One cup of all-purpose flour. One teaspoon of baking powder. 1/8 teaspoon of salt. Extract and 1 16-ounce can of Hershey's chocolate syrup. Yeah, that goes in the cake. It's gonna be good. Okay, and then for the frosting for the cake, oh, we're not done yet. For the frosting, it's gonna take 1/2 cup or 1 stick of butter. Yeah, so that's 2 sticks of butter for this cake. That's gonna taste so good. So 1/2 cup of butter, 1/2 cup of semi-sweet chocolate chips, 1 cup of sugar, 1/3 cup evaporated milk, which is just awesome, 1 teaspoon pure vanilla extract, and 1/2 cup chopped pecans or walnuts. People just love this cake. Okay, so here are the directions. First, you're going to preheat the oven to 350 degrees Fahrenheit, and you're going to grease and flour a 13 by 9 by 2 inch pan. Then, using an electric mixer, cream butter and sugar together until light and fluffy. Add eggs one at a time, beating well after each addition. Sift flour, baking powder, and salt together in another bowl. Add to the creamed mixture and continuing to beat the mixture. Beat it good. Then you're going to add vanilla and chocolate syrup to the batter and mix well. You have no idea how good this smells once you get to this step. It's, oh, it's amazing. Then you're going to pour into a prepared pan and bake for 25 to 30 minutes. Just before the cake is done, you're going to prepare the frosting. Put the butter, chocolate chips, sugar, and evaporated milk in a saucepan over medium heat and bring to a boil. Stir ingredients together. Boil for 2 to 3 minutes. Remove from heat and stir in vanilla and nuts. And you don't have to put nuts in if you don't want to. Then pour over the warm cake. So it's important to do the and then